Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. We haven't had the launch of KPLO yet, but we can still hopefully expect it to lift off this week. The SpaceX fans website is not updating this launch properly, so we'll take a look at the SpaceX Now website. You can see that we can hopefully expect the KPLO launch tomorrow, Thursday 4th at 11:08 PM UTC or 7:08 PM EDT. Jonathan McDowell posted a great picture on Twitter of the Starlink constellation. He said, "Here is a plot showing the instantaneous locations of all the orbiting Starlink satellites at 0 hours UTC August 1st. You can see some of the recently launched trains and a small number of polar sats. There were a series of tweets posted related to SpaceX's efforts to minimize Starlink reflectivity. The first says, to mitigate the effects of Starlink satellites on astronomy research, SpaceX has developed a space-stable dielectric Bragg reflector film that reduces satellite visibility by an order of magnitude. SpaceX will also be offering this film at cost to other operators." Next, this tweet was posted saying SpaceX has also developed a low reflectivity black paint which is 5 times less reflective than the current darkest available space-stable paint to coat various reflective Starlink satellite components. After that, this tweet was posted saying SpaceX has also developed a special opaque coating for the backside of solar arrays and a special satellite maneuver called Terminator tracking to mitigate reflectivity. The final tweet posted says SpaceX continues to work closely with the astronomy community to mitigate the effect of all satellite operations on their important work. SpaceX engineers will be presenting in person and answering questions on August 9th, 2022. There was a Space News article posted related to the Polaris Dawn mission. It says, in an appearance at the Experimental Aircraft Association's Air Venture Air Show in Oshkosh, Wisconsin, July 29th, Isaacman said he expected the mission to fly late this year. "We are looking at the end of the year right now, so likely December." Heading to Boca Chica, work continues on the orbital launch mount in preparation for a booster. Engineers have also been working on the Starship quick disconnect arm. The work on Star Factory in the production yard is continuing as always. Work is going on with this tent by the Mega Bay. This tent is currently being deconstructed. The Starlink loader was moved out of its new processing building and into the yard. I wanted to share this cool tweet from RGV Aerial Photography for those who may be unaware of where Starbase is in relation to the surrounding area. Elon Musk posted a tweet with information about the timeline in which we could expect to see the first Starship orbital flight success. He said, "A successful orbital flight is probably between 1 and 12 months from now." Work has been continuing on Starship 24 and the suborbital Pad B launch mount as they prepare it for a static fire. Looking at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, originally just the closures on Monday and Tuesday were cancelled. However, whilst there were possible closures for today and tomorrow, those have also both been cancelled now. The scrapped Booster 5 aft section was lifted off of the transport mount. Super Heavy Booster 8 continues to be worked on in the Mega Bay. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, also known as Boca Chica Gal, and Nick Antsuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.